Hi, I'm Jim Park. Welcome to this HDT Leadership Insights podcast. This episode is sponsored by and produced in partnership with PrePass Safety Alliance. 5 years ago, the Commercial Vehicle Safety Alliance added the Level 8 electronic inspection to its North American Standard Inspection Program. It's a solution that's widely been touted as a way to increase the number of inspections done on trucks. CVSA is also looking at inspection requirements for automated commercial vehicles as well. Steve Vaughn has some thoughts on the Level 8 inspection program. Steve's the Vice President of Field Operations at PrePass Safety Alliance. He served nearly three decades with the California Highway Patrol, and he's the past president of the CVSA. Before we dig into Level 8 electronic inspections and autonomous commercial motor vehicles, remember to follow and connect with us on social media and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss an episode of HDT Leadership Insights or HDT Talks Trucking. Steve, welcome to Leadership Insights Podcast.
Thank you, sir. Glad to be here.
The board of directors at the Commercial Vehicle Safety Alliance approved the Level 8 inspection to the North American Standard Inspection Program back in 2017. It's been on the books for a while. What is an electronic inspection? What sort of information or data would be exchanged between the truck and the inspection site?
The North American Standard Level 8 electronic inspection is an inspection that's conducted electronically or wirelessly while the vehicle is in motion and there's no direct interaction with the enforcement officer. The truck will transmit information on both the truck and the driver. There are several things that are required, which include a descriptive location, including GPS coordinates, driver information, such as current driver status, hours of service compliance. Then on the vehicle, the US DOT number, power unit registration, UCR, or the Unified Carrier Registration, and if there's any federal out-of-service orders placed on the vehicle. The list is much more comprehensive than just those items, but to be considered a complete Level 8 inspection, all the data must be exchanged and received, all the data, the applicable data points.
And how would they go about getting that information off the truck and into a format that can be transmitted electronically? I'm thinking kind of specifically here about some of the driver information. I mean, that's on their CDL, probably in their back pocket. That's going to be a bit of a challenge.
It will be very challenging. Generally speaking, what they're looking at is using the electronic logging device or the ELD. That will provide the information. However, the information will be sent and received in what format has not really been determined or defined. The concept is it would be transmitted through one of the onboard telematics, such as the ELD. But to the best of my knowledge, they haven't developed a standard data exchange protocol, which needs to be defined so that the vehicle can transmit it and the weigh station can receive it. And furthermore, probably more important is who's going to pay to put this infrastructure in place.
I guess there's going to be a lot required too if they're going to have, well, every inspection station in the country at some point, and presumably every truck in the country at some point. That's going to require some major investment, I would guess.
Absolutely. And they're not only talking about major the facilities that are existing today. We've heard from at least one state where they're talking about putting it throughout the state just so they can monitor where the vehicle is at any given time.
So a mobile transmitting site or a fixed position that's not necessarily an inspection station?
That's correct.
Okay. How is this going to happen then? Obviously, you got to get an awful lot of people sitting around the table to come up with communications protocols and concerns about safety and privacy of the data. And, you know, it's, I guess, protection from cyber attacks. There's still quite a bit of work to be done on this, I would guess.
There is. There's a number of work groups that are out there today. You've got primarily through CVSA and ATA and other trucking associations where they're working through all those details as we move forward. Obviously, anytime information is being transmitted, there are certain protocols, security protocols that will have to be met. Fortunately, industry and the state and federal government agencies are working together on how to make that happen.
I mentioned off the top that this could have some application with autonomous vehicles. Certainly, trucks have to be inspected, but with no driver on board, that's going to be a little bit awkward. So how would they go about getting data that they need from a vehicle with no driver? I presume a network of sensors on the truck sending information somewhere?
Yes, that's absolutely correct, Jim. For autonomous vehicles, the information will be obtained through the onboard telematics. The system can monitor many of the critical components on a truck. However, it doesn't monitor all the components on the truck. For example, in the discussions I've seen or been part of to date, they haven't really resolved the issue of the trailer or the load. That will not be monitored based on today's discussions. There's also things that simply can't be monitored. For example, if there's a crack in the frame or a broken spring. Fortunately, we're still in the early stages, so a lot of these things will be worked out. And what information, the final data that will be exchanged, will be determined through these discussions with industry and the government.
Whatever the application turns out to be for autonomous vehicles, it seems that traditional fleets are going to be exposed to this first. What's your reading on how fleets think of this? What are they comfortable with sharing that sort of data with DOT unprompted and unannounced?
Well, that's an interesting question. I think today when they're discussing autonomous vehicles, they're looking at a driverless vehicle. However, the way I see this is eventually what's going to happen is that is moving ahead of the level 8 in discussions today, although I understand FMCSA is going to be looking at level 8 and pushing that a little bit more. My opinion is once you establish what's required on an autonomous vehicle, you're doing that saying this vehicle is safe. Why would you not then apply it to vehicles that do have drivers? And that's where the level 8 will come in. I think in this discussions to date, what we see is they're coming together better on what information should be exchanged. However, I find it kind of interesting. In recent years, there's been a lot of discussion in Congress regarding the VMT or the vehicle miles traveled tax. Mm-hmm. With this new type of system, it will be much easier for regulators to accurately determine where that vehicle has been. It'll also be better for enforcement to help with the hours of service violations. Because you have to remember, the idea is the information's being transmitted on every truck traveling down the road, whether it's being pulled in or not. That data can be collected and examined at any time.
Okay, so there's you said a mouthful there in that one.
I did.
We've already got hours of service enforcement that's pretty reliable vis-a-vis the ELD. All the form and manner violations more or less go away. Vehicle mile tax, yeah, we can collect that. We're not too sure if we want to do that or not yet as an industry. Some seem to still prefer the fuel tax model, but who knows what happens when you don't put fuel in trucks anymore. That's going to raise some interesting questions. It sounds like 24/7 surveillance in a way. Have fleets expressed any concern that you're aware of what they might be giving up in terms of this additional surveillance or what that information might be used for or who eventually claims ownership of it?
I have not heard a great deal of discussion as far as what the fleets may be giving up. I think it could be a concern for the fleets. It could also be a concern for the states. When you have this information floating out there, if you know that there is a problem on a truck and action is not taken either by the carrier or by enforcement, the state, there's always going to arise a question as to who's responsible and who's liable for allowing that truck to go down the road. So I think though there are a number of questions like that that need to be addressed and need to be answered prior to autonomous vehicles actually hitting the road on a large basis, I would say, because they are out there today.
Back to traditional fleets for just a second. Would this be a two-way communication between, or a three-way, I guess, between the truck, the DOT, and the fleet? For example, you mentioned liability for a problem. If the electronic inspection reveals that there's some safety concern, let's say an out-of-adjustment brake, DOT knows about it now. The stroke is, you know, two brakes, one brake, overstroking. Can the fleet be notified that, hey, you know, unit 123 just passed our inspection site. We noticed there's a brake out of adjustment. What are you going to do about it?
That's one of the unanswered questions. With autonomous vehicles, they've clearly identified that if anything is out of adjustment, is not working properly, that truck will receive a signal to bring itself into the facility. Mm-hmm. However, since this does not apply to the traditional driver vehicles, that really hasn't been discussed or resolved. I would think technology would allow it to be a two-way communication so the driver's made aware. But what's not resolved is what actions is that driver required to take? Pull over to the side of the road and stop if it's not in an inspection facility? Pull into the inspection facility? That's still an unknown that needs to be addressed.
Yeah. Well, there's certainly some exposure to being pulled over on the side of the road, which raises another set of questions, I guess.
Absolutely.
Steve, you were the president of CVSA from 2000 to 2001. You probably have a pretty good idea how that group works. Is it just up to CVSA to decide what it wants in terms of data, or are other parties involved in those discussions, figuring out what's going to be flipping back and forth over these networks?
First off, you have to understand CVSA is made up of states, provinces, local authorities involved in CMV enforcement. It also has a very, very large contingency of the transportation industry that participates. In addition to that, there's representation from the DOT, state safety organizations, both state and national trucking associations. All of those people together have a voice. During the committee meetings, there's a great deal of discussion. So it's well beyond CVSA. It involves federal agencies, state agencies, and industry themselves coming together to find that solution to improve safety.
Okay. And final question before we wrap up here. The PrePass Safety Alliance, your company's in business of providing bypass services for good carriers at scales. You're already into this electronic thing in some way, shape, or form. How does the company, or how do you feel about this going forward with the level 8 and the automated electronic inspections?
Certainly, the PrePass Safety Alliance, our primary focus is safety on the highways. We do monitor trucks today, pull some in if there are certain criteria that are not meeting the state requirements. We're very actively involved with CVSA, with the safety organizations, with the federal government on identifying where we're moving in the future. So we are participating in these discussions. We're on a number of committees, our staff members are, and we're very interested in where it's going and we'll adapt and move with it.
Thank you, Steve. That was a great discussion. Something to keep our eye on and watch carefully moving forward.
Thank you for having me.
Steve Vaughn is the Vice President of Field Operations at PrePass Safety Alliance. If you'd like to learn more about CVSA's electronic inspection program, I invite you to listen to the full interview on the audio version of the HDT Leadership Insights podcast. Steve and I will be diving a little deeper into topics of interest to truck drivers, fleet owners, vehicle maintenance specialists. Remember to follow and connect with us on social media and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss future episodes of HDT Talks Trucking. I'm Jim Park. Thanks for watching.